is dead, but it's not, because it's a movement. House music is a movement. It's not just like hip hop, rap, or something that comes and changes. It stays the same, but it moves and it evolves and it moves people and it brings people together in a calm and a very civilized kind of way. And that's what house music's about. That's what I'm about. That's what Gene's about. That's what his partner Roz is about. That's what it's about.
With house music, I think anybody who's a DJ, producer, and so forth, who's into this scene, would like to see the music go further as far as reaching the younger audience to kind of keep it going to the next generation. That's, I would say, the reason why they say house is dying, because it's at a certain age limit, and once those people are out of it, you know, that's basically it. So
let the freak inside of me show ya that love for more than a moment. Happiness here for you and me. Y'all having a good time? Do you want to do more? Are you ready for more? Are you ready to get lifted?
Of house music. How did I get involved with Hotter Than July? Raz called me last year and said, look, you know, I'm doing this other project. It's going to be called Hotter Than July. Is that a good name for a project? Yeah, Hotter Than July. And the music is hot, so why not?
Oh, when will there be a harvest for the world?
There was a group of children who kind of like was like, wow, I'm curious about this new thing, this house music, because these children are beautiful, but they love like what their culture exposes them to. And that is predominantly like a hip hop thing here in Bed-Stuy. I got some of the children involved on the stage with dancing with me. So I kind of felt like the Pied Piper, just kind of leading them on and them following me, and then like just recognizing the beauty of the music, because this is the next generation. Look at these kids. They're just like this beautiful with smiles on their face. They just like, you know, they just need a lot of exposure to a lot of beautiful things. And that's what we're trying to do with the children here in Bed-Stuy. But that's what we're trying to do with the parents of the children here in Bed-Stuy. And that's what we're trying to do with all of the house music heads. Just expose them to more good music, to more love, to more beauty in life. And that's a wonderful thing. Look, she put her arm around me. I'm so blessed. This is love. Can we get a rap? Can everybody say yeah?
Oh, when will there be a harvest for the world? Yeah. When will there be? I wanna know now. When will there be a harvest? 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 When will there be? When will there be? Everybody, I'm talking about the children. When will there be a harvest? When will there be?
Somebody scream!
When I was carrying my children and listening to this, they're out here somewhere. But you know what? This is universal. This is love right here. This is a community. And we all here for each other. We love each other. We support one another. Can't get no better than that, baby. Can't get it better.
Yeah, because some of y'all may have never seen us, but you know of our music. So just to let you know that we are still standing. This year, we are celebrating our 25th anniversary tour. I'm going to dedicate this next song to the New Sky fans, okay? All the New Sky fans, check this out, okay?
Hi, this is Barbara Tucker. Yes, you know the number one diva of house music. Been in this business for 22 years. Some people, they go around the world to find what has been always inside them all this time, and that's the love of house music. Someone asked me once, why do I keep coming back to house music? How about I never left it? I mean, basically, when we started this thing, you don't start off saying, oh, I want to do house 22 years ago. You just start singing. It's my home. It's what's in my blood. I love it. It's a lot of inspirational music that involved. And this is the door that God opened for me. So this is the door that I welcome and I keep walking through.
There is no other. You are my God. But when I confronted you, you fell in love with the room. What am I supposed to do? Oh, you're strong.
Yes, y'all, I'm Daryl DeBonneau, and we are talking about house music. That house music is all about love. I give back. I'm here today singing. Barbara Tucker was here today, and we gave for free. So sometimes you need to come out and see what house music can do. You don't have to pay us all the time, but show us some love, and we'll come out and do what you gotta do. Give us an ear, you know, and check it out. Everything you hear about Brooklyn, it ain't true. It's all over the world. So come on back and check out house music. Again, I am Daryl DeBonneau. Singing, I've got to find a better way. I work hard from day to day. So do you. House music is in the house. God bless, one love.
What's up, world? This is your boy Big Chuck, otherwise known as DJ Champagne. And this event is called Hotter Than July BK. All right, we bring it to Brooklyn because Brooklyn is now where everybody's coming for all the culture, all the food, and all of the vibe. All right, everybody was down on Brooklyn for a minute and now they know that this is where it's at. All right, I got involved with this with my boy DJ Raz, and I am at DJ Gene behind that. And because of them and their spirit, I come and I show love and I do whatever they need me to do to keep this thing moving. You need to come out and see us. Holla.
Tell them, Rocks.
Gotta love it.
Summer's over when we say so.
That's right.
Before I get into anything else, I want to thank everybody for coming out here, trooping out here off of one train during this weather with everything else going on. I'm having a good time tonight. I hope you are too. We're going to come back next summer. Let's give it up for Mr. Carlos Sanchez!
Carlos Sanchez, DJ producer, started out as a musician, and I ended up as a DJ in the early 70s, following the underground clubs, and I've been doing this for over 30 years. Well, we have a community of people in this underground. We have a scene called the Underground House Music Scene, and there's a few of us who are still trying to make it. We're not mainstream anymore. So there are quite a few of us who still support each other, come to each other's parties, you know, and try to be each other's eyes and ears in our own community. It's difficult because we don't get the mainstream attention that, let's say, hip hop or the R&B artists get.
Thank you.
I think house music has stood the test of time. You know, I'm 52 years old, and it's still around, and I'm still loving it, still enjoying it, people still enjoying me, so I continue to do it. I just want people who put out house music to get the respect that they deserve as producers and writers. You know, and the rest will speak for itself, because if the music is good, people will dance, they'll go out and buy it.
Who are you, sir?
Oh, I'm DJ Big Bob, man. Glad to be out here in Von King Park on a Saturday afternoon, evening, having fun with DJ Raz and DJ Gene, Hotter Than July. I'm ecstatic that they asked me to come out and play, because I've been in the skate world for 30 years, but dance music is where I come from the clubs and the garage and the Loft, Better Days, and all the club scenes, you know. Thank you very much. All the club scenes, you know, it's where I come from. And I play drums, I sing gospel, so dance music is a part of spiritual for me, man. It's like catching the Holy Ghost, man, when you feel the music, you know. So me to come out and go back to my roots and play a little house music, dance music today was a beautiful thing, and I'm glad I came out.
King Park, believe me, it's going to be on the map. And I mean, like, you have in New York City, you have your Jazzmobile at Grant's Tomb that has been going on for almost 30 plus years. I plan on being in Von King even longer than that. As long as that establishment is there and the rapport with the center and the 79th precinct, as long as they are helping us and granting us the permission with the Parks Department, we will be there. I'm looking at bringing in people, DJs from all over the world. I already know I'm looking into the whole Chicago connection, but at the same time, there's gonna be a whole lot of activity happening with Raz, myself, and the whole Hotter Than July concept. It's gonna happen. I know it's gonna happen. It's not an if, it will happen.